He is also very devoted in searching the way in which architects should deal with the issue of sustainability today in order to respond to future challenges. With other words, he is exploring what's next. So please join me in welcoming the great architect, Vinnie Maas.
Okay, let's start. I'm so happy to be here, back after, what is it, 9 years ago, 8 years ago? And when I was standing on this cliff and looking through there, and I saw this gorgeous, like, pristine waters, and with this kind of secession towards Stefan Zweig, Stefan and Woodfall, and I was like, this is that spot that you noticed maybe, and it was like, what can we do with that site? And it was kind of Russian owner at that moment with a very dubious back that wanted to do this with that. And I said, my God, what is this? But that's your situation.
I like this somehow.
And we started to say, what can we do? Do we want that really? And I was looking to the other places that you so much know, and I'm aware there's a lot of development coming up and you like it partly. And it's not that bad yet, but on the other hand, it is serious, man. Because if you look further, maybe there is some kind of nicer part coming up, one would say. But that's other developers in the audience, because they always use this kind of slogans. New quality of life, they say. What is this new? Or is this something I've seen before? I love this car at the moment that I was showing. That exactly this is what Montenegro's coast is simply showing. A kind of explosion of sex, drugs and rock and roll that somehow want to compete Ibiza, if not the whole of Spain. And then I saw this in a Dutch newspaper at the same moment, but there are some of you that were protesting against it. I don't know how it is at the moment in that way. And I was like, what can we do? So we said, no, so they accepted at that moment to enter the competition, and we found out that you had a very nice law. There's an FAR, a floor area ratio on this site, which is 1. And that's actually okay, FAR 1. Because then I can just cover the whole site. I can manipulate it to the road, higher up, make a better entrance over there, make even some more penthouses over there, that's it. And so this is the landscape at the very spot. I just cut it away, put it on top, and put everything below. And I start to manipulate the entrances in such a way that you have a hotel or a resort at the moment, and cut away in all the patios for the houses. It is a very easy plan, because you can make one-story houses everywhere, and you make roads in between that bring you down. That's all. It's a technique that doesn't cost anything. And you cover it with that blanket that I stole away. So here is what the section is showing, how we did that, cutting away, piecing it, putting things up, etc. And let's say make this kind of vertical, let's say, apartment as such, with this view towards Stefan. So and yes, we could use it to also to drag it over the parking lot, we could drag it over the interior hall, and then you would have this kind of say, sequence in a way. That would be the first part of that complex, that hotel complex, up till it finishes in the sky and forms the next peak. This would be the structure to start with, but then this would be the real structure at the moment, and this would be the perspective, and this would be the image now from, let's say, Stefan. And my Russian client asked me, where is my resort? Exactly, that's the point, Alexander, because that you show at that moment that this is your prestigity is what you get, and you don't have, but I want to be present. No, the best presence is to be non-present in this environment as such. And this is how you can then make your rooms in a way. And if you can walk between the rooms, and goats can nibble on all the jasmine, the jasmines and all the bushes that are there, and just go from the bottom to the top after they reach the lobby. That would be a dream to do. And even in the evening, when I would sail around from Greece up to the north, and then I would discover gradually this kind of new mountain at that spot. And then I'm aware that the next James Bond will be here at that moment. And then you would solicitate to much deeper, say, enterprises of the planet. Why don't you do this, is my question. Why aren't you organizing yourself in such a way that you protect yourself to maybe one of the biggest horrors that you could imagine? So this, what's next? The good thing of my terrace is that you see now the Russians didn't survive, the bank was corrupted with another bank, and now the parcel is plotted out. I'm having a dream now about a book that comes out soon that explores this what's next, this curiosity. And of course, that goes and talks about time, and it wants to, like in Gideon, somehow to understand what time can be. And with that, I do hope that I give you some kind of ideas of that future as such. And I thank you very much for your attention. For his name is Tarkin Tolan.